Welcome to VGAI TV. In this video, I'm discussing the few questions from rational numbers. See the question. Question number 11. Shruti uses 105 7x8 gram of wheat flour for making half kg of halwa. So they are given 105 into 7x8, or it's like a mixed fraction. They are given 105 7x8 gram of wheat flour making half kg of halwa. Approximately how many grams of halwa she can make with 315 3x4 gram of wheat flour. Okay, so what we are doing first is, what is the meaning of this number 105 7x8? Mixed fraction we are converting to improper fraction as 105 7x8 gram is equal to, multiply these two number. If these two number, if you multiply, 105 into 8 is 840. 840 plus 7, 847 divided by 8 gram. So this is nothing but 847 by 8 gram. Okay. That of wheat flour we need for making how much halwa? Half kg. Half kg is nothing but 500 gram, because 1 kg is 1000 gram. Therefore half kg is 500 gram of halwa. So I understood 847 by 8 gram of wheat flour, 500 gram of halwa. Now what we are doing is, 1 gram of wheat flour means how much halwa we can make it. That is, we are using a unitary method. 847 by 8 gram of wheat is equal to 500 gram of halwa, means 1 gram of wheat means 500 divided by 847 by 8. That is 500 into 8 by 847 gram of halwa. Now, how much wheat we have now? We have 315 into 3x4. Convert that mixed fraction. 315, 3x4 is nothing but 126 3x4 gram of wheat flour. 126 3x4 gram of wheat flour. We converted this. How we are converting? 315 into 4 is 1260. Plus 3, that is 1263 by 4 gram of wheat flour making. We got an answer here, right? This 1 gram is this much halwa. So this much gram means it will be 500 into 8 by 847 into 1263 by 4. We multiply it. These two we are cancelling. We will get it as 2, means 1000. It means 1263000 by 847. If you do, I will get 1491.145 gram. 1491.145 gram. So this is called a unitary method. Two things you should know. How to convert this mixed fraction to an improper fraction. How we are doing? We are multiplying these two and we should add with this. Okay. Multiply these two number and add with this. Here also multiply these two number and we should add it. So that idea should be there first. So I got it. This is nothing but, this number is nothing but 105 7x8 is nothing but 847 by 8. 315 3x4 is nothing but 1263 by 4. So what we got it? This much gram, 500 gram of halwa. So 1 gram, how much halwa we did. Then for this much gram. So 500 into 8 by 847 into 1263 by 4. We get an answer 1491.145 gram. Okay. Next question. Which of the following number does not lie between minus 1 and minus 2? See the number, they gave it like this. Okay. Minus 1 and minus 2, they told a number, they gave it like this. If you see this type of question, you check the number denominator 10, 10, 5, 10. So what I am doing is multiplying both numerator and denominator of this number with 10. So 1 I can write minus 1 by 1. I am multiplying both numerator and denominator with 10. That is minus 10 by 10. Second number, minus 2 by 1. Multiply both numerator and denominator with 10. That is minus 20 by 10. So we got a number. The number is minus 10 by 10 and minus 20 by 10. If you check it itself, you will understand. See, minus 10 by 10, minus 20 by 10, minus 13 by 10 anyway in middle, minus 15 by 10 in the middle, minus 16 by 10 in the middle. But we are doubtful about this. minus 4 by 5. Minus 4 by 5, how to make the denominator as 10? Multiply both numerator and denominator with 2. Minus 4 into 2, minus 5 into 2. So it is minus 8 by 10. So it's sure that minus 8 by 10, it won't come in between these two. So which is your answer? Minus 4 by 5. Clear? How we are doing? We got a number minus 1 and minus 2. So what I did is, I checked in the answer, they gave it like a denominator in the form of 10. So I multiplied both numerator and denominator with 10 for both the numbers. So minus 1 by 1, 10 we are multiplying means minus 10 by 10. Minus 2 by 1 also 10 we are multiplying means minus 20 by 10. Then we understood minus 16 by 10, minus 15 by 10, minus 13 by 10, all lies in middle only. But minus 4 by 5 means multiply both numerator and denominator with 2. So we get minus 8 by 10, that it won't lie between minus 10 by 10 and minus 20 by 10. Next, 9 times the reciprocal of a rational number is equal to 6 times the reciprocal of 70. 9 times the reciprocal of a rational number, I don't know the rational number, I'm keeping it as x. 9 times of the reciprocal of the number, what is the reciprocal of the number? 1 by x. 9 times means 9 into 1 by x is equal to 6 times the reciprocal of 17. So 6 into 1 by 17. Cross multiply 9 into 17 by 6. That is 51 by. We are getting a number. We cancel these two terms. So this become 3. This become 2. 3 into 17. 51 by 2. 51 by 2. We can write it as what is 51 by 2? 2 2's are 4. Reminder 1. 11. 5 2's are 10. Reminder 1. How to write the number? Quotient, remainder and divisor. So we can write quotient as 25, remainder as 1, divisor as 2. So what is your answer? 25 and 1 by 2. Clear? 9 times of a reciprocal of a rational number. So 9 into 1 by x is equal to 6 times reciprocal of 70. So 6 into 1 by 70. Cross multiplication, we got the number, but this is not there in the option. So we converted 51 by 2. Clear? Next, the numerator and denominator of a rational number is in the ratio 5:7. When 6 is added to both numerator and denominator, the ratio becomes 4:5. What is the rational number? They told the numerator and denominator in the ratio 5:7 means, I am taking numerator as 5x, denominator as 7x. Okay, so what is the ratio of 5x by 7x? We cannot take directly like a 5 and 7 because it's a ratio. So we can write it as 5x, 7x are the number. They told to add 6. So 5x plus 6, 7x divided by 7x plus 6. We get a number 4 by 5. Cross multiply. 5 into 5x, 25x plus 5 into 6, 30 is equal to 28x plus 24. This term going that side, 3x is equal to 6 and x equals 6 by 3, that is equal to 2. If x is equal to 2, what is your required number you see? X is equal to 2, 5x, so 5 into 2. 7x, 7 into 2, that is 10 by 14. Or we can write the answer as, what is answer? Required number is 5 by 7. 5 by 7. Anyway, they gave that the ratios are in that form only. Okay. So, in the same form only it should come. If you are doing some other operations in middle also, there ratio always remains like 5 by 7. So check it how I did. I have taken the number 5x and 7x. They told 5x you add 6 with that. 5x plus 6, 7x plus 6. We get a number as 4 by 5. Cross multiply, I got x equal to 2. After that I am finding the number 5x and 7x. It is 10 by 14. It's not there in the option. So I changed. I divided both numerator and denominator with 2. So it will be 5 by 7. See the next question. Subtract the sum of minus 1 by 2 and minus 4 by 7 from the sum of 3 by 4 and minus 5 by 7. So I need to take the sum of both the number first. These two number we need to add it. These two number we need to add it. Then we should take the subtraction. So first from the sum, so this number should come first. 3/4 plus minus 5/7 minus next number minus 1/2 plus minus 4/7. What is the LCM of this number? 4 and 7. LCM is 28. 28 divided by 4 is 7. 7 into 3, 21. Minus 28 divided by 7, 4. 4 into minus 5, minus 20. Minus 7 and 2, LCM is 14. 14 divided by 2, 7. Minus is here, so minus 7. 14 divided by 7, 2. 2 into 4, minus 4, minus 8. So it is 1/28 minus, these two when you are adding, minus 15/14. Minus minus will become plus. 1/28 plus 15/14. 28 is the LCM. 1 plus, 1 plus, what is the number? 2. So we will we can write it as 14, 28 divided by 14 is 2, 2 into 15 is 30. So 1 plus 31/28. Check it what we did. Only one thing, you have to understand that how to add two fractions. We have to take the LCM. What is the LCM of 4 and 7? 28. Then 28 divided by the first denominator, that is 28 divided by 4, 7. 7 into 3, 21. Next, 28 divided by 7, 4. 4 into minus 5, minus 20. Minus, this minus. 7 and 2, LCM, 14. 14 divided by 2, 14 divided by 2, 7, minus 7. Plus, 14 divided by 7, 2. 2 into 4, 8. Minus 7, minus 8, minus 15. So if you add it, we get an answer 31/28. Okay, clear? Thank you for watching VGuide TV.